Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In this series, we're going to cover how to master Dolby Vision deliverables, which have been introduced in the Flame 2021 products. There is support for Dolby Vision 2.9 and Dolby Vision 4.0, and this is available in the timeline as well as batch, enabling you to have HDR workflows ranging from simple mastering tasks all the way up to complex conform workflows. Now, Dolby Laboratories developed this HDR format to make the most of high dynamic range and wide color gamut technology. So its main purpose is to provide the content producer with some control over how HDR masters will play back on displays that have less dynamic range or color gamut. Dolby Vision has become one of the deliverable standards, and it has been implemented with various content streaming providers such as Netflix, Amazon, etc. And in order to view the content, Dolby Vision has also been added across a range of displays, including the latest UHD viewing hardware. So in the Flame products, you can master Dolby Vision, as well as edit the Dolby Vision metadata with a sophisticated yet flexible suite of tools. This can all be achieved without having to leave the application. So this series will cover the breadth of using Dolby Vision in the Flame products, and I'll assume that you have a general understanding of Dolby Vision. If you need to familiarize yourself with Dolby Vision, as well as their best practices and hardware display recommendations, please visit the Dolby website. Now, in terms of monitoring your Dolby Vision masters, the Flame products support both external and internal mapping units, or CMUs, to apply the Dolby Vision processing. Please refer to the Flame online documentation for a detailed explanation of the various supported configurations. Now, before I show you how to master in Dolby Vision, here are a few startup pointers to help you out. For example, when setting up a project, ensure you use a progressive frame rate in order to support Dolby Vision. Do not use interlaced or progressive segmented frame rates. Finally, when it comes to color management, all media needs to be properly tagged, and you'll want color transforms appropriate for HDR work. If you don't already have your own HDR color policy, we recommend you start with the provided ASUS 1.1 policy. Moving over to the preferences, you can choose your default Dolby Vision algorithm version. In terms of displaying your imagery, you can choose between three options. You have the ICMU, which is integrated software, the ECMU, which is an external server, or HDMI tunneling to preview the grade on a Dolby Vision compatible display via HDMI. You can also set your default mastering display based on the supplied Dolby Vision configuration file shown below. Now, you can configure your displays in the broadcast monitor preferences. But don't forget to go to the color management preferences to set the broadcast color space and the monitoring color space to Rec 2100PQ and set up your broadcast monitor accordingly. This ensures that your external display and scopes are correct for Dolby Vision. With all that said, here we have a graded HDR sequence that was provided in Rec 2100 at 1000 nits, and its color space has been tagged accordingly. Now, you'll see the outcomes on your various displays, but to ensure technical accuracy, I recommend enabling your scopes to monitor the Dolby Vision output. This can be done by toggling Alt 4 or using the player options pull-down menu. You would also need to set the scopes to monitor in PQ, either manually or using the HDR preset. This ensures that you can monitor all forms of HDR and SDR content as you master in Dolby Vision. Now, to start working with Dolby Vision in the Flame products, it is incredibly straightforward. call up the context menu over the track containing your HDR graded sequence, and choose to create a new HDR track. Two new video tracks are created. If you expand the names of the tracks, the track above the edit is the PQ track, which ensures that any underlying footage is converted or maintained in Rec 2100 PQ for Dolby Vision. We will discuss this more in a future video. The second video track that was created is the HDR track. This track holds the HDR timeline effects, which contains the Dolby Vision dynamic metadata. Since you have HDR timeline effects as unique segments, rather than being locked to the edit or as a global setting, you have much more editorial control over the Dolby Vision metadata to deal with any potential issues when mastering. I'll cover some more scenarios in a later video. Now, the next step after setting up the timeline is to ensure you have the correct mastering display before performing the Dolby Vision analysis. You can select one or all of the HDR segments. In the effects ribbon, you have the HDR mode where you can set the mastering display for the analysis. So based on its settings, Flame will take the Rec 2100 PQ master at 1000 nit and output that as a 100 nit Rec 709 SDR signal. The deliverables can be set using the target displays, and it is recommended that you always start with the Rec 709 SDR 100 nit target display. Now, this output will be created via the Dolby Vision ICMU, or Integrated Content Mapping Unit, running in Flame. However, if your facility is configured with a Dolby ECMU or External Content Mapping Unit, you could use that to generate the Dolby Vision SDI output for a separate monitor in order to keep the original HDR master on your broadcast monitor. Switching to the Analysis menu, you can choose from a range of analysis settings. But since this is the first time, you would select all shots and click Analyze. The analysis is performed using the GPU, and the L1 analysis metadata for Dolby Vision is produced. This contains the minimum, maximum, and midpoint value for each shot. So this output is for the 100 nit Rec 709 SDR target display. If you need to have additional target displays as part of your Dolby Vision deliverable, you can go back to the HDR mode menu and choose a new target display. Since the analysis is based on the mastering display, you do not need to redo the analysis. Adding a new target display does not overwrite any previous ones, and you can switch between them. All metadata is stored separately for each target display. Now, one point I'd like to highlight about the analysis is that when it comes to a transition, like a dissolve, the dissolve is not recreated on the HDR track. Basically, the analysis is taking the transition into account and is part of each HDR segment. The situation will be different with other transitions like wipes, but we'll touch on that in a later video. One other scenario you might get with the analysis is when it comes to a letterbox. Take this shot for example. By default, the entire content within the frame is analyzed, including the letterbox. This creates the incorrect values for the analysis. To rectify this, in the analysis menu, you can go to the active image area. When you dial in the correct ratio to exclude the letterbox, this creates Dolby Vision L5 metadata, which is considered during the analysis. Now, if this affects the entire sequence, you can reanalyze all the shots with these settings. However, if this is just a single shot, you choose Current or Selected Shot and click Analyze. The results update, and now the Dolby Vision analysis is correct. If you're happy with the look on the target displays, you could go straight to export. Now, I'd like to mention at this point that setting target displays, performing the analysis, and even exporting the Dolby Vision deliverables is included with the Flame 2021 products. However, if you need to adjust a target display to match the creative intent, this will require a Dolby Vision license to access the additional creative functionality. This is the same for other applications using Dolby Vision technology. As a tip, if you already have a site license for other products, the same license should also be valid with the Flame products. Just install it in the HDR Timeline Effects Setup menu, and the Dolby Vision L2 and L8 trim controls will become editable. Now, the trims are accessible in two places. Firstly, you can use the effects ribbon above the timeline. In the trim menus, your controls will vary depending on the Dolby Vision algorithm choice. For example, you can tweak the L2 trim controls for Dolby Vision 2.9 or the L8 trim controls for Dolby Vision 4.0. Each target display will store its L2 and L8 metadata for the trims, making multiple Dolby Vision deliverables quite seamless. The second place to access the trims is in the effects environment. This exposes the full toolset, including animation tools and more. You have the freedom to choose how you'd like to work with Flame, and the workflows are interchangeable. Finally, creating your Dolby Vision deliverables is also a straightforward process. Switching to the Media Hub, you navigate to a destination folder. Next, export the sequence by dragging the clip into the folder. From the export choices, you choose Distribution Package. In terms of a standard Dolby Vision deliverable, you need to output the Dolby Vision metadata as an XML. So choose to output the XML using either Dolby Vision 2.9 or Dolby Vision 4.0. When the export is complete, you now have a Dolby Vision metadata XML file that you will submit with your HDR graded master as part of the deliverables. Now, before I conclude this video, there may also be a requirement for review and approval. So you can also export a baked version of a target display that will not require Dolby Vision encoding for viewing purposes. To create the output, you repeat the same export procedure as before. However, this time, under the Dolby Vision presets, you can choose a Dolby Vision Preview Master preset, and this will bake the Dolby Vision ICMU processing into the image. After exporting, this produces the Dolby Vision metadata XML, as well as a watchable movie file that could be sent for client review and approval. So this quick start video has given you an overview of the Dolby Vision technology in the Flame 2021 products. We've only covered the basics from in to out, but please check the Flame 2021 documentation for more detailed and technical explanations. Over the coming videos, we'll go into a lot more detail of what you can do when it comes to mastering with Dolby Vision in the Flame products. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to the Flame 2021 products. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.